Hello everybody, in this video now we will study about sexual reproduction in plants. In previous lecture we learn about asexual methods of reproduction in plants. Now about the sexual reproduction. As we know, sexual reproduction is most common process or method of reproduction among the higher plants, in which formation and fusion of gametes occurs, and for that meiosis is very essential. Meiosis is a type of cell division. It is essential. These are the two important things which are essential for sexual reproduction. One is formation and fusion of gametes, that is fertilization, and meiosis. By meiosis, gametes are formed and thereafter they fuse so as to form zygote, and zygote undergo embryogenesis. It means that here we represent that in this way. By meiosis, gametes are formed, then gametes undergo fusion, their union occurs so as to form zygote, and then zygote forming embryo by embryogenesis and embryo forming new plant, which is dissimilar genetically to parent plants. Because here in sexual reproduction two types of gametes form, is a formation is an important process, and because of two dissimilar gametes, means compatible gametes, allow for fusion and thereafter zygote formation occurs, and then by division, repeated cell division, embryo formation occurs, that is called embryogenesis, and embryo undergo germination so as to form new plants. But newly formed plants are genetically different from parent plants. Okay, this is the central theme of the sexual reproduction. As we know, sexual reproduction requires specialized organs because it is the advanced and complex method of reproduction as compared to asexual reproduction. That is why there is a need of a superior type of organs that are called reproductive organs. In plants, particularly in angiosperms, flowers are the organs of reproduction. A typical flower bears four types of floral holes: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Out of four holes, two holes, calyx, corolla, are non-reproductive, non-essential holes, while androecium and gynoecium are the reproductive holes, which are direct role in sexual reproduction. And in this way, we can say that angiosperms, means higher plants, developing special organs for sexual reproduction, which are, flowers are absent in lower plants like alga, bryophyta, pteridophyta, etc. Okay, now in short we will learn about the structures of typical flower. Typical flower have calyx, करोला सपोज इट इज अ स्टॉक कॉल्ड पेडिसेल देन इट इज थैलेमस और रिसेप्टाकल थैलेमस प्रोड्यूसिंग ऑल फ्लोरल होल्स कैलिक्स करोला कैलिक्स करोला देन एंड्रोशियम एंड देन गाइनोशियम हियर दीज आर नॉन रिप्रोडक्टिव means they have no direct role in the sexual reproduction while androecium and gynoecium have a direct role in sexual reproduction that is why I call reproductive hole and these are non reproductive holes or non reproductive leaves they are essential that is why also called essential holes and among these two Androecium is a male reproductive part of flower and gynoecium is a female reproductive part of flower and these two structures are essential for sexual reproduction then we will study first about the androecium it includes an anther and a filament anther is a fertile structure filament is a narrow slender solid structure called filament which is sterile on another hand gynoecium includes stigma style and ovary okay here gynoecium have stigma then style and then ovary in this way stigma style and ovary are the parts of gynoecium one means single individual structure is called stamen stamen is a individual member of androecium male reproductive part and carpel is the individual or a single member of gynoecium okay in this way we will learn about stamen anther and filament is equal to stamen stigma style and ovary is equal to carpel okay now first about male reproductive part stamen it includes anther filament and a part where the anther and filaments are connected called connective filament connective and anther are the three parts of stamen okay then we will study in details about the stamen okay now first about the stamen stamen contains filaments and either one or two anther lobes it is the anther but
anther is one lobed called monothecous anther, having one lobe. Here two lobes are there, one and two. That is why it is bilobed or two lobed. Okay, two lobed, one lobed, monothecous. Here bilobed is called dithecous or bithecous. Mono for one, monothecous one lobe, dithecous two lobe. Majority plants have a bilobed anther, and when we take section of anther, then there are special type of arrangement inside the anther. Anther has outer wall called anther wall, and inner important structures which producing pollen grains called pollen sacs or pollen chambers. Okay, one lobed means monothecous anther have only two pollen chambers, two pollen sacs. That is why called, therefore called bisporangiate, means pollen sacs or pollen chambers are called sporan, microsporangium or sporangium. But here in case of dithecous anther, here only two pollen chambers are there, here four pollen chambers are there. That is why four pollen chambers or four pollen sacs, that is why called tetrasporangiate condition. Tetra means four and two means bi. Okay, in this way bisporangiate or two pollen sacs having condition. Tetrasporangiate means four pollen chambers having condition. Okay, now when we take section passing through this bilobed anther, when we take section of bilobed anther, we will observe two lobes. In between them there is a connective and wall of anther and pollen chambers into which pollen grains are developed. Okay, now we will learn about the histology of, means TS of anther. Here TS of anther. Anther is the apical fertile part, reproductive part of a stamen. It is anther. And anther hold by a sterile filament. One flower contains few to many stamens. In this way, it is called a stamen, male reproductive part of the flower. And we taking section passing through anther, where anther cut open, we observe like this. This type of condition means here like this. When we cut anther lobes, two lobes, we observe like this. Two lobes connected by a connective. Okay, here it is the transverse section passing through anther of a flower. Outermost covering of a anther is epidermis. It is made up of flat cells. We can learn it only using this half part in this way. Outermost covering of the anther is epidermis made up of epidermis. It is outermost single layer made up of flat cells, and main function is protection of internal part of the anther, that is the pollen chambers. Okay, epidermis, below epidermis there is a radiating layer, radiating cells are there, elongated cells are there arranged radially, but they have a thick wall like this. In this way, these are the radially arranged elongated cells forming second layer of anther wall called endothecium. It is below epidermis. Then it is also single layer and made up of elongated cells, but their walls are thick, thick walled cells. The cells are elongated and having thick wall. Okay, then inner to that there are some loosely arranged cells are there. They have either one, two, or sometimes many layers called middle layers. This is the third layer, one to two layers, sometimes more. Parenchyma cells. Then, now fourth layer, that is called tapetum. These are the cells arranged in such a way that they cover, encircle the pollen chambers or pollen sacs. Pollen sacs means the spaces covered by this layer, fourth layer, cells of nutritive cells, that is called tapetum. It is innermost layer, single layer of nutritive cells, which encircling the spaces called pollen chambers, pollen sacs, or sporangium or microsporangium. Okay, and here now the remaining part covered by middle layers, cells arranged in this manner, and now and here there is a connective tissue, a cells which connects both lobes called connective, means a wall of anther starting from epidermis, then endothelium, middle layers and tapetum. It is the wall from here to this, epidermis to tapetum, the wall of pollen chamber, and the wall encloses the chambers or sacs called pollen sacs, where pollen grains are developed. Formed here inside the pollen chambers, first the inner tissue is called sporogenous tissue, which forming the microspore mother cells, means pollen mother cell, and pollen mother cell divide by meiosis to form pollen grains, that is called microsporogenesis inside the pollen chamber. But outside the pollen chamber, this is the parietal cell, parietal layer of cells forming the wall of anther. And during young condition, entire anther filled by parenchymatous tissue, which later on differentiate into archisporial tissue forming outer parietal layer, inner sporogenous tissue. Parietal layers forming epidermis, then endothelium, middle layers and tapetum, which forming the wall of anther. And inner important part, that is called pollen chambers or pollen sacs, formed by microspore mother cell or sporogenous tissue. Here, first of all, microspore mother cell or pollen mother cells are formed, which are diploid. They undergo division. In this way, diploid spore mother cell, microspore mother cell or pollen grain mother cell divide by reduction division, so as to form two cells which are haploid, because it is a meiosis first. Then in meiosis second, again four cells are formed which are haploid, called microspores, means pollen grains. Four microspores are formed, means four pollen grains are formed inside the tissue, here inside the pollen sacs from sporogenous tissue forming microspore mother cell, means pollen mother cells. Pollen mother cells divide by meiosis first, meiosis second, in this way forming two and four cells. Diploid pollen mother cells forming haploid pollen grains. And in this way, this process is called microsporogenesis inside the pollen chambers. Here, in this way, the one cell forming one microspore mother cell forming four microspore, or one pollen mother cell forming four pollen grains, that is called the mass of four pollen grains is first of all attached, that is why it is called tetrad of pollen grains or microspores. Here, in this way, the tetrad is formed, and later on they separate many pollen mother cells forming many pollen grains. And when the anther become mature, here is the depression, estomium, means the site of dehiscence. It is the site of dehiscence. Dehiscence means the site, place where the wall of anther ruptures and pollen grains released out, and that is called as dehiscence of anther and discharge of pollen grains. When anther become fully matured, then this middle layer gradually disintegrates, and the size of pollen chambers increases continuously, and finally they become fully developed, full grown, their growth occurs and they get mixed so as to form one big structure. And here there are many pollen grains, haploid pollen grains or microspores are formed at the last stage of development. And when the fully matured anther contains many pollen grains, is now ready for dehiscence. Dehiscence means it's breaking, because now pollen grain producing lot of pollen grains, and pollen grains are required for pollination. That is why it's rupturing, means dehiscence is essential. And here on the lateral side there is a dehiscence site where the invagination occurs, and in this way the tissue degraded, disintegrated, and the opening is formed, and the pollen grains which are formed inside the pollen chambers of a matured anther now ready for release. And in this way pollen grains are released out after dehiscence of anther. Now these pollen grains which are released, discharged out, ready for pollination. In this way we learn about the TS of bilobe, means Diathecus anther. Subscribe the channel for more updates. It motivates me to make more videos. And don't forget to share this video to NEET and CET aspirants.